Hello and welcome to this edition of Goa 365 Story Behind the Story. It's been a very eventful week. The borders have been opened, permissions have been given for bars, hotels have been open earlier, no doubt. And there has been some, there has been a broad daylight murder in Margaon. So all these things are, this may seem unrelated, but ultimately they are all related to the name of Goa, to brand Goa. Welcome guys, Nilesh Shah from TTAG. Reginald Lorenzo, MLA, the firebrand MLA from Kuttori, Advocate Siddharth Samant, our legal expert, and Cruz Cardoz from the Shacks Owners Association will be joining us shortly. We are having some connectivity issues. Welcome, guys. Now, Reginald, I would like to start with you for you to give us a political sort of a political this to the whole thing. Little unbiased if possible on both sides, government as well as this, about the whole situation. Tourism, we need money, we don't have money, the economy is very bad, Goa is tourism related, plus our brand image is going down, this Sushant Singh the thing has come into Goa, and now this murder. So could you, we'll start with you, Reginald.
See, right now we are in an ocean and we are trying to survive. If you go to see,
yes,
everybody wants the economy to come up. Jobs are not there. Everything is not there.
Yes.
There is no money. It is a fact. But first, it is at the cost of health. Second, it is at the cost of safety. Third, it is at the cost of the well-being. Munche, well-being mulagiden. Scenario is like that, where it is a gloomy picture. You know, you are depressed situation. Now, police and crime is the second part, and the third part, you know, is like how to, you know, manje where to draw a line. Now see, tourism, if you wanted to start, what will be the, you know, suppose hotels you want to start, suppose restaurants you want to start, who will come finally? It is people who have to come. Which people? Outside people who are coming in, they are there, and secondly our people. आता कितले काय येना, काय स्टडी ना तेजेर, कितको करपाचें काय ना. स्टार्ट केलें. सेफ्टी मेजर्स तुम कितकोतले. एमएचए इज व्हेरी क्लियर. एमएचए हॅज सेड दॅट यू ओपन अप, डू वॉट यू वॉन्ट, बट एवरी स्टेट वील हॅव हीज ओन प्रिकॉशनरी लिस्ट. म्हणजे कितें आहा, वॉट दे हॅव टू डू टू प्रोटेक्ट देअर स्टेट, दे हॅव टू डू. आता बिकॉज ऑफ द सिनारियो ऑफ इकॉनॉमिक्स, आता मर्डर मातशें जावपाक शकलें. ताका लागून आमी कितें केलां, ही आतां फर्स्ट केस जाल्या आफ्टर लॉकडावन. एक्शन म्हणटा तें सारकें प्रॉम्प्ट जावपाक जाय. ताका जाय जाल्यार यू नो, इट इज अ सिट्युएशन वेर यू हॅव टू स्क्वीज द फेलोज, अदरवायज द नेक्स्ट थिंग वील टेक प्लेस. सो इट इज ओनर्स ऑफ रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑन द पुलीस, ऑन द होम डिपार्टमेंट टू टेक एक्शन. सारकें फूल तो कोण जावं, तो मागीर तें कोणूय जावं, ताका भितर उडोवपाक जाय, तेजी एक्शन घेवपाक जाय. टुरिजम इंडस्ट्री प्रोटेक्ट करपाकूय तेंय करपाक जाय, आनी टुरिजम इंडस्ट्री जावं तुगे हॉटेल्स कितको प्रोटेक्ट करतले आनी मुखार वतले, वाड ना जाच्याक कोवीड केसीस हेजेर, यू नो, दीस वील बी द सिनारियो. आतां पॉलिटिक्स चोवपाक गेले जाल्यार म्हाका दिसता, यू नो, आय जस्ट सेड वी आर फिशींग इन ट्रबल वॉटर्स. वी डोंट नो वॉट टू डू बिकॉज देर इज नो डायरेक्शन, देर इज नो, यू नो, वॉट टू डू. नाव आय फील दॅट देर शूड बी स्टील, यु नो, सगळ्या मेन कन्स्ट्रक्टीव्ह एफर्ट गेन, कॉन्फिडन्स गेन, डेलिगेशन ऑफ पॉवर्स करून मुखार वचपाचे. नाव इट इज लेफ्ट टू द
ओके. निलेश, नाव In the government has given permission for hotels, for restaurants, and now also bars. Only thing left probably maybe a little later would be casinos. So, but there are issues faced by business from the time we spoke last to now. Now, how many of these issues have been sorted out? I all of us have to be optimistic. We don't doubt that. But how many of those issues have been addressed, and what exactly is the present status as of now?
Frankly speaking, we welcome the decision of opening up of the more opening up of the industry under lockdown 4. What at time really we are start requesting the government that they should open up the hotel. So what happened was, the people, the government checked up with the protocols accordingly, the calibrate manner they allowed the hotels to open up. after opening of the hotel, the number of people who applied hotel were around 350. And actually, hotel which started were hardly around 250 odd. And out of that, many closed down because they were no business.
Okay.
Now, there are many reasons for having no business into Goa. The one of the major reason was the protocol which we are following, where that's what we analyze it. So now after in the fourth thing, now no, the protocols have been removed. Was there right now in holidays, 15 August, Raksha Bandhan, the Rajasthan has done extremely well business. Manesar has done very well business. The hotel occupancy was almost 80-85%. Reason was there was a free flow of borders between Gujarat and Rajasthan, MP and Rajasthan, from Delhi to UP, Delhi to Haryana. So there were a lot of crowd which was there, so business was happening. So with opening of this, I think there should be some improvement of the tourism. As far as tourist business is concerned, as a whole, in Goa, the requests which were asked for government were plenty. None of them have been come through on the pretext of no funds. Now only the thing which we got it was the electricity high tension charges, which that also thanks to the center, wherein they had given some relief to Goa government, and partly around 2 crores of amount which has been benefited by the tourism industry as a whole. So now presently now our focus is that domestic tourism is going to be a major thing in days to come. And secondly, we have already requested government to announce the charter policy. We can say, of course, it is a center subject, but then Goa government has to push to allow the charters to come from November onwards, from October onwards. There are plenty of flights which have already applied into coming into Goa, specifically from Russia and UK. So government, there is no this thing that they will allow or not. So under that bubble scheme, the charters has to be allowed into Goa, so that small hotels also start the operation, which benefits this charter business is right from category 1 category to 5 star category. Everybody gets some pie of that business.
Okay, let me interrupt you on this charter bit. I just want to get Dottor in on this charter, this Dottor, and then Reginald. You know why? Dottor, see, now charters depend on brand Goa. Okay, now it's I'm little deviating slightly from the topic, but brand Goa has taken a beating. Be it the Sushant case, where the drug connection, the NCB has arrested some people where party drugs are supposed to come from Canada to Goa, and then yesterday the broad daylight murder. So what do you feel, will, as a legal man, what should be done for this to improve? What is your thing, take on that? Then I'll go to Reginald, because this is a slightly sticky point for tourism, for brand Goa, for the image of Goa.
Surveillance is required. We have to have a strict scrutiny of everything, from where the drugs are coming, other things. See, basically, unless you make a conducive atmosphere, the image of brand Goa will always take a beating. We have to do this in a planned and a phased manner.
Koshe, sir.
It cannot be done in a superficial manner. It needs to be, because see, as far as drugs, there are two, three sides to it. Drugs angle is totally different issue than what has happened in Margao. It has also no connectivity with borders being thrown open. Drugs and other issues which are there will have to be looked into by NCB and other agencies in a scientific manner. Unless that has been done, the image of the brand Goa will always take a beating.
Dottor, Reginald, what you feel now, the brand, you are one brand of Goa, Reginald Lorenzo, everybody knows you now, but brand Goa for tourism, which the industry which Nilesh represents, and which a lot of Goans, now mining, I don't know if we'll ever start, whether it will never be the way it is like this, but it is tourism on which Goans are surviving. They are going to make money. The common person is making money, supposed to make money, may not be making, but if the image is not there, what are we going to do? What do you have to say on this, especially with charters and all? I heard you putting up
your overall picture of what is required right now.
mining, you have to auction it, and with that revenue, maintain a balance between economics of Goa. One second.
Yeah,
economics
go on, go on.
Of Goa
go on.
And can you hear me?
Yes, yes, go on. Hello.
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yes. Go on.
Hello.
Yeah, yeah, go on, go on.
I'll keep coming in. Mining has to be auctioned, and with that revenue, economics of loans have to be looked after. Economics of the state have to be looked after. The tourism can go simultaneously. I am not against tourism. Let tourism go simultaneously. Let them have a boom with safety measures. All these drugs, full action, full blast. You have to frame somebody and put him inside so that there is care. That murder, you have to convict it and do something with it, fast track it and do something and do something. If required, even if required, I don't know whether maybe there are some encounters, I don't know what, something, anything can be done to improve the brand image of Goa. If we do this part, brand Goa to be, you know, intact, these two things. And the last part, the charters have to be open. If they have to be opened up, they have to be told first because people need to plan and get the charters. Now, if all these things of first mining, second economics, third drugs and all these murders, and the fourth economics of the tourism after the state can survive, with rider on it is the safety of the people. And next, last point, see that there are less deaths as far as COVID is concerned. This is the entire scenario. Look at it.
Nilesh, now Reginald speaks sense, but however, how is it possible for this safety to be ensured? But more importantly, now the industry needs some of this, but there was an issue about registration fees being raised and then electricity bills. Nilesh, can you hear me? Hello? Nilesh, can you hear me? Yeah, so we were talking about this, what Reginald is saying. Now, what I'm saying is about the government. Yeah, the government needs to give some help, but then instead of helping, it is raising rates. Now, registration rates have gone up. The electricity issue has not been sorted out. So, how is it that boost is going to be given to this if these, I think you all have made some representation to the government and all that. So, how is it? Now, shack owners are shouting that, but we have not got crews. But otherwise, so what is the way?
What? So I tell you, there are two to three ways which we are, like this increase which they are talking about. It is in pipeline for last 2 years. So what we are saying is, of course, we'll give our dissent to that, and we will say that to postpone it, and it has to be more rational, because in certain cases the increase is almost 2000%, so which is not called for. So that is one aspect. So what we have suggested government for the help, which we are working from oversight. Now, Kerala government has given some scheme. So on similar line, we are requesting Goa government to give it to all tourism stakeholders.
Okay.
Now, the scheme is such that, you know, the interest subvention. Now, the banks just charging, suppose, 9% to the customer. So all tourism stakeholder, the 4% of the interest government can, you know, do give the subvention where they pay directly to the bank, and the tourism stakeholder get loan at 5%. Now this is can be for 1 year to start initially if they cannot. So for 1 year, even if they give, and if suppose in that case they just give it for 500 crores of amount across all board, right, from small taxi owners to the shack holders to the medium-sized hotels, small travel agents, tour operator, everyone. Now the exchequer will have a expense of, means a budgetary expense of around 25 crores for a year, which they can, you know, definitely give it some budget if they want. Because anyway, the tourism is going to be there are a lot of promotions are not going to happen. So
correct.
That is one scheme which we are suggesting to the government. And it can be benefited to everyone. And one important point, you know, is that positive messaging, which has to go from all stakeholders. It is not only the hoteliers or only travel agents or tour operator, government, even the smallest of this thing has to send a positive message on the social media. Because what we see in the social media, you know, lot of negativity, like our own Goan people only sending the negativity.
Yes, yes.
The people sitting in the UK,
I totally agree.
Pass the comment on this. So what we are looking into is that positive messaging that we are welcome into Goa, we are going to take care of it. Of course, this COVID situation is not going to remain same. It is going to decline in 1 month or two. And with the vaccine coming in November, December, we have to start planning. Reason being, because if you want business for December, January, then we have to start planning now, because the business does not come often. We'll have to start promoting, and we have to emphasize on the safety angle, and we have to emphasize on the positive messaging that all of you are welcome into Goa, and we'll take care of you into Goa, and not to worry about anything in Goa.
Now suppose if this becomes like Dharavi or Dongri, this is about a month, 2 months back, somebody attacked somebody's house with a gun. Then there was some extortion, and then there was some business related extortion, and then there was attack some guy celebrating on the roads with swords, and then some guys in the Kolwal jail doing videos. So ultimately then what is the difference? Why would Goa want to come? And the type of people going in. So what you feel about this thing? What is the solution? How to clean up our act?
Only solution is to have a strict policing about these things. As far as yesterday's Margao incident is concerned, the police have nabbed the accused in time. But that doesn't mean that the image has not taken a beating in other things. The other things which has happened have been very brazen, and that needs to be dealt with in an iron hand. There is no question. You don't look at it from political angle or other thing. It's just a law and order situation which needs to be, police should be given a free hand. There should not be any political interference, and that's the only way as far as law and order is concerned, which can be cleaned. As far as shacks are concerned, unlike many times in past where CRZ is to take days for the purpose of clearing of files and other things, at least government can speed up the process and fast track things, so that at least putting up the shacks, getting them electricity content, getting them water at a subsidized rate and in quick and efficient manner, at least those things can be fast tracked, so that at least infrastructure is in place, the business is set up. Because in any case, now you have allowed interstate travel, so slowly the tourists from the other states will come here. So at least on that counts, we will be prepared, and there should be some movement in the society, some movement in the market, some money will come in, and it will speed up our economic activities.
I have a point to add here, Dottor.
Government can do that.
I have a point here, Dottor. Now the problem is the shacks, restaurants, all types of businesses, hotels, like travel agencies, everything. All that is fine. Cruise, small restaurants. But the problem is tourists should not be allowed to come and cook on our Goan roads. They should not go to the fields and bring that. I have seen with my own eyes. In fact, I had spoken to the late CM also about Miramar. He didn't believe up till I showed him. They bring their own rice. They bring their own dal. They bring gas. They bring wheat. And they fill petrol in Goa and go back. They're making a profit. How are we going to do business like this? And what are the politicians doing that they are not forcing the cops to take action? I've seen them. Ponas rupiah, 100 rupiah, they take and they finish. How are Goans going to do? Nilesh?
Correct.
Yeah.
As far as these tourists are concerned, Goan business owners do not earn anything. Even rice and dal they bring from their state. Petrol also they bring. Whatever.
Exactly.
They, those things also are brought.
And a profit. It's less here in there.
We have.
Nilesh, that we have to pay for. Nilesh. Yeah, Nilesh.
Can I come on?
Yeah, Nilesh. Nilesh. Yeah.
Everywhere throughout the world, wherever you go, there are, you know, there are different type of tourists which come in, right, from budget tourists to the elite tourists. Now, this budget tourists which come in, we need to provide them some facility, so, and charge them for the same. So, if facility is provided, I think surely, I think they will come on board and they will have to pay for those facility. So, we have so many open areas where we are saying these tourists are coming in. So, what we are saying is there should be a camp areas which should be designated throughout Goa or wherever, 2-3 parts, in more in the hinterland, so where they get benefit out of it. Wherein once they go inside those camp areas, there has to be toilet, there has to be cooking facility, and everything has to be charged strictly. And people who are on the road, by chance, if anybody caught, we have to direct them there, and there should be strict penalty on them. So what happens, you know, it is like unless we provide that facility and create that infrastructure, which is not a big thing, and we can start charging them, make a revenue out of it, and then we'll see less of this dirt on the roadside also. So there has to be clear-cut policy, and which as a TTAG, we have been requesting government for quite some time in doing it. And they also say that the rules are there, but I don't see them in implementing it. So we have to work on this.
That and is the whole problem.
We have to insist on certain things which are, you know, part of the benefit of the Goa as a whole.
Reginald, see, this is the main problem. Now, see, nobody is going to act up till there is a political pressure. I remember in Miramar, we had put a lot of pressure when the former CM is there. But now again it started, and now with yesterday we heard there were so many vehicles have come in from across the border. Now, I don't know how many hotels are getting full, but I'm sure they will be going in Miramar or wherever. So the political will. So you as a member of the premier opposition in Goa, I think Chief Whip Mardu, what are you going to do? What are you going to do to put some pressure on the government here?
See, I agree with Nilesh. It is so unfortunate. After so many years of BJP rule, I think they are not able to put one small thing. You gadi aata hai to ek designated place kon tank anchor pass hai na. See, the whole idea is that the whole system has collapsed. Because why? Because there are too many greedy people there. The problem is they focus aapla git mate chopa jaye gaon aage bor kar pa moni sali nahi dinga. So aata now let us go to that point. See, if that thing is ready, those fellows will have designated places, somebody will earn there, and somebody will make some money. Blank property is Shatant, and the Friday market and Thursday market, Shatanguru Laglite, Shatan parking on tank place, there revenues at all, the drugs we bond at all. Interest now. Okay, let's come to the point. Now, what I'm saying is the government needs to do these things on a very weak war footing, otherwise, the situation will not improve. Now, to improve it, I am of the firm opinion. माइनिंग म्हणते ऑप्शन जाऊ बघाय त्याच रेव्हेन्यू गेलो काय ना पण टॅक्सीवाल्या सगळ्या अप ब्रिंगिंग त्यांचे लेवल वर सोडली काय ना दे विल बी रियल हॅपी दे विल कोऑपरेट विथ द टुरिझम इंडस्ट्री ऑल्सो नाजाल्यार टुरिझम इंडस्ट्री ते कोण येतले आणि त्यांना पैसे एक्सट्रॅक्शन करतले नाल्या हे मर्डरूय देवतली आणि ड्रग्साचे जो तर अटॅक मारली परतून हांव तुका त्यांची रिपीट करता ड्रग्साची अटॅक मारली आणि ड्रग्सान दोग जाणां भितर उडयल्या तेंची भिरांत आयली ओ मर्डर डिटेक्ट जालो मर्डर म्हणजे क्विक एक्शन इज नॉट इनफ एक्शन म्हणते conviction about within your fast track it put conviction do something you know
yes here absolutely Jodhana, totally Iran agree yes
so all these things have to be done if brand Goa image has not to be dented or rather if it is dented to correct it and bring Goa back to the path of progress so come on.
Dudar, I want to add one thing. Now, this is not so much you as a lawyer, but as a member of civic society. Now, we want tourism. Everybody wants tourism. Everybody wants the economy to improve, to become better. But as civic society, what type of tourism are you looking at? So or do you want in Goa?
So that's very important in promoting your brand. The manner in which you promote Goa, and that would be by way of good law and order situation. See, if there are drugs instances, and if you make headlines for the drugs, a particular type of tourist will always come. If you market it well, a man is known by the company he keeps. So what kind of news that we are making, what kind of infrastructure we are getting, what kind of advertising we are getting, kind of brand we are promoting, that kind of tourist will come. So if you want a particular type of tourist to come here, then we will have to make a conducive atmosphere for that type of work. Only then these things will happen.
Absolutely.
First, law and order has
yes.
to improve.
Yes.
If the
Absolutely.
Law and order does not improve, if the police, if the tourist does not feel safe, secure here, then a different kind of tourism will start here. So therefore, first of all, these things
yes.
have to be handled.
Yes.
If you do not handle these things, tourism will always be in chamber. And it will be always, we will be making news for wrong reasons.
Reginald, I want to talk on one point on cruise. We'll get back to you later. We'll add you later. Reginald, I have one point I want to talk about is this small restaurants and hotels, small bars, any taxis, because you are a man on the ground. So how important is it that these people are encouraged? Even about that tourist coming, no? Now, a lot of us have got sheds, fields, you know, which we don't use. So the government should expatriate, do some sort of a thing. So we can, Goans, people from Goa can use these empty lands and make some money, no?
आयडेंटिफाय करून जाय खुंचे शेत ती बेस्टे खुंचे शेता परमिशन दिवपा जायना बरी शेता परमिशन दिवप ना ना जाल्यार तें बरी शेत आहाय तें कोण घातलें हे नांव सेकेंडली लेट अस बी वन थिंग लेट्स द गव्हर्नमेंट यु नो अक्रॉस पार्टी लाइन शुड सिट टुगेदर लुक आफ्टर द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ गोवा
यस हॅलो
कोण करतलो आणि कोण करतलो ते खे जाय गव्हर्नमेंट फुडें आहा तो कांय डिसिजन फर्म घेवपाक रेडी ना कित्याक दे हॅव द ब्रूट मेजॉरिटी इफ दे वर नॉट हॅविंग ब्रूट मेजॉरिटी एंड इफ हा गायज वर नॉट कनायमिंग विथ देम वी वूड हॅव अ नो प्रॉब्लम वी वूड हॅव अ गूड गव्हर्नन्स नाव हें सगळें फेल जालो आहा आतां सिस्टम सारको तो जाल्यारी चीफ मिनिस्टरान ओ जावं कोणें कोण मुखार वचपाक पडटलें नाल्यार हें जावपा ना सो हें करपाक ट्युरिजम इंडस्ट्री जाग्यार घालची पडटली इकॉनॉमिक्स जाग्यार घालचे पडले सगळे जाग्यार घालचे पडले कितको घातलो ऑल स्टेक होल्डर्स टेक देम इन टू कॉन्फिडन्स एंड डू इट आस्क फॉर हेल्प बट फायनान्स हूंय हाडटलो व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट आनी कोविडाचे डेथ कितको रिड्यूस करतलो दॅट वील बी द बोथ एंड पॉइंट्स फायनान्स व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट फायनान्स कितको हाडटो तूं ट्युरिजमाचे फायनान्स येत तो पुर न्ही ते भायर सद्या लॉस आसना हांवें तेंगे लोन फारीक करूंक जायना तेंको भाड्यांगे तेंगे सिट्युएशन कितें आहा तें सो तें सिट्युएशन केलें बगर तें केलें बगर आनी इकॉनॉमिक्स वाडयलें बगर तुगे स्टेट सगळें थंड जावपा ना क्रायम रेट देंवपा ना आतां क्रायम रेट देंवपाक पुलिसांनी एक्शन घेवचें पडटा सी ऑल दीस थिंग्स आर इंटर रिलेटेड डिप्रेशन
एब्सोल्युटली
सगळें देंवतले फायनान्स कितको येतालो तूं जर तर मायनरां हेल्प करतलो हे टायमाचेर हितूंत ते मिनेरान तुका हितूंत तें तुमी मिनेरां हेल्प केले आत हेल्प करपाक जायना आतां घरचे टायमाचेर तुवें तेंक सांगपाक जाय बाबा दीस इज द एंड ऑफ द डे पॉलिटिकल डील जाय आतां इवन मेडिकलाक आय बीन सेईंग एक मानिपाल हॉस्पिटल हितू ऑर स्टेट जोडले डोनेटेड लँडाचेर आतां हे टायमाचेर तेंकां स्क्वीज करपाक जाय आसले आमको बील ना कित्याक आमी तेंगे गुलाम आहाय रिक्वायर सम रिक्वायर सामडी मॅन ना जावपा ना हे नाजाल्यार हे आमगे आनी दोशीर वयतले वॉट इज टुडे आय प्रिडिक्टेड टू मंथ्स बॅक वॉट विल बी द सिट्युएशन टुडे एंड नाउ आय एम टेलिंग यू इन आनी आल्या तर 3 मंथ्स कांय जावपा ना हे कडे कित्याक बील ना हे करपाक आहा तू सांग
एग्री विथ रेजिनाल्ड
टू एन एक्सटेंट येस
दोतोर यू एग्री विथ रेजिनाल्ड
एज फार एज स्मॉल बिझनेसमॅन आर कन्सर्न टॅक्सी ड्रायव्हर्स आर कन्सर्न they need some help because see they are not in a position to pay their installments for their vehicles they are not in a position to pay their license fees for different licenses which they have so they need Correct. Some moratorium yes. on their loan amounts they need some rebate concessions on the interest and they need some sort of a support encouragement by the government where they get some they are facilitated to do their business Unless that happens, they will not be able to crumble under the present circumstances. So they need at least for next six months, they will require some sort of a support, some sort of a help, some sort of a push, some sort of an encouragement, some sort of a package which will allow them to sustain for this period of time.